Marvel vs. Capcom 3 Fate of Two Worlds. It's a single player game, it's a multiplayer game, and it is a player versus player game. Third person perspective, and well, let's start just with the gameplay. You have lots of characters, around 40 to 44 characters which you can choose of. And you play also four characters free, like Hachinko, Taskmaster, the Sentinel, and Akuma. You play them, you get them if you unlock them if you play the game, and every time you finish the game, doesn't matter which character you play with, you unlock a character. Each character has three superpower abilities. The superpower abilities are different per character. One has beam weapons, the other has pistols, the other has grenades, like Chris Redfield from and Albert Wesker from Resident Evil. The Hulk has gamma powers and smashing powers, and so on, so on, so on. You can choose only one power if you play the game for each character. You can choose three characters in your team, and you can each give them one superpower. So, you can use, for instance, the Sentinel with his rocket powers, the Hulk with his gamma blast, and of course Taskmaster for his arrow power. With what does it mean? The Hulk, you know, he can use his gamma rays and smash things of the enemy and hit them with it. Then of course you've got the Sentinel, he just shoots a lot of rockets and it hits everything on the screen. Then you get, for instance, the Taskmaster. He can shoot an arrow at an enemy's head several times, like 20 hits. And that's useful if you play against certain characters. So if you choose your characters, choose their abilities so you can combine them together. You can also use all two powers of certain characters. So, for instance, you are fighting against another one, and you know, my superpower isn't enough, I need another character. So just push the button and another character of your team jumps in and uses his power too. Well, mainly you can use all three of them, but... So, they all combine their powers, shoot them at once at the enemy, and they just hit the enemy really in frontal attack, and they just go down. Of course, the enemy can also do that with you. Underneath the screen you have a energy bar. The energy bar can fill itself 5 times, and that means you can use 5 times your superpower. And of course there are different types of attacks and enemies. Like if you're fighting on the ground you have certain combos, but if you go in the air, jump high in the air, you can use different kinds of combos. When you're in the air your attacks change and have another effect. Like Thor, if he's in the air with his hammer, he can just fly at an enemy down, waving with his hammer, and hit them all. Then of course we have Spider-Man, who can also web sling and use web powers, and Deadpool, who can use his knife, his sword I mean, and of course his pistol. If you combine those two characters, they're really fast, you need another character, like a really big one, like the Hulk, or She-Hulk, or the Sentinel, like that one. Why? Because the enemy also has certain times a really big enemy, and if you have a really fast one, you know, you can take a big enemy down. But if you have a big enemy and you don't have any more fast characters, then you have your big enemy like the Hulk, who can take down a Sentinel easily. So that's useful to think about those moves that you're gonna make and characters that you're gonna choose. So a lot of superpowers, a lot of characters, and really great gameplay. Really, it is just great fun, and a lot of movement on the screen, a lot of flashing screens, a lot of superpowers, a lot of fighting, brutal action, you know, I love it. If you stand behind an enemy, you can make a throw them over your shoulder or some other move. Each character has his own move in that way. And of course you can choose from the Marvel comic superheroes and the Capcom characters, like the Resident Evil characters, and they're fun. Chris Redfield, Albert Wesker, so much fun to play with, so much different weapons, and it's useful to combine those two in a team, you know, mortal enemies, and they now work together to take down Galactus. So that's fun. The story, you know, it's simple. Galactus is on his way to devour and destroy the Earth, and you just have to stop them by defeating all the enemies and then destroying him. Yeah, and the control types are, well, you've got normal, which I use, and you've got, well, I believe they call it simple, the mode. The word simple just popped up in my screen and I thought, oh no, I don't want to be simple, I just want to be normal. Well, and then we get to the difficulty levels. You've got very easy, easy, normal, hard, and very hard. Very easy says it all. Easy is really nice to practice and learn the move. Normal is challenging. Hard is a tough one. And very hard, well, it's not impossible, but it's nearly impossible. And I enjoyed it very much. The superpowers like from Phoenix and the Wolverine, they're just great to use and play with the Sentinel and everything, or the Hulk. And the endings of the game are okay. The endings of each character has its own ending, so you have to play the game several times for each character to see its own ending. Each ending is different from each character, and it's just like a little bit of a comic book. You can see a few pictures and text that's coming to your screen, and the pages flip to the next page, and that's it. So the big intro that I've got also online is really well made, beautiful to watch and great fun, but it's not, you know, the ending of the characters isn't compared to the intro great. So the intro is great and the endings are okay, you know, that's what I'm trying to make a point here. It's okay, the ending. But overall, gameplay, graphics, multiplayer, player versus player, you know, it's just all great fun. So if you compare to the price for the game, well, we at Gamers Unite always think that the money that they ask for the game, it's not fair, should be $30 or less, you know. But for this game, you know, it does score high on the fun that you have, a 10, but on the price, again, we just gonna give it 7 or 8, and so it's an average of about an 8 it's going to get for the price and the fun. But it's great fun and it's a great game.